When the asset grows over time, you may not need to do a job. Everyone wants to become wealthy, but only few have a plan in mind. Welcome to Katosh Tubes. I'm your host Paras, and in today's video, I'm going to tell you how to make a money machine that works. If you are a student, working professional, or a retired gentleman, this video is a must watch if you are looking to build a money machine that works. So, let me get started with today's video. Behind me, you can see a set of blocks. And with these blocks, we will create a money machine that really works. So, without any delay, let me get started. So, there are three blocks, 1, 2, and 3. So, number one block, I call it a block of income. Income means the way you earn your money. How much you earn at the end of a month will comprises of the income block. And the second block is divided into two parts because that contains your savings. And the second is your expenses. Saving means the money you save at the end of the day or at the end of the month, and expenses are your expenses for the day. I will describe them in detail once I fill all the boxes. And then we come to the third part, this third box, which is asset. And second is liability. Now, in simpler terms, asset is something which puts money in your pocket, and liability is something which takes money out of your pocket. So keep this simple definition in mind. As we go further, you will understand it when I give the examples. So here are the three blocks: income, saving and expenses, assets and liabilities. So around these blocks, we will create a money machine, and this money machine requires a lot of discipline and dedication from you. If you want to build a money machine that really works, in reality, a total legal system, you need to be disciplined to make this money machine works. Now, let me get into the detail. So when I talk about the income part, it is the salary. If you are a employee, you will earn a salary at end of the month or end of the week, depending upon your payroll. And if you are a businessman, you will also earn an income at the end of the month. So this comes your income part, which is always a positive number. And from income, your next step should be to go to savings or go to expenses. Savings are the amount which you keep aside for either for emergency use or to grow your wealth over time. It can be divided into cash. You can have a hard cash as a saving. It can be divided into deposit, like your bank deposit. So one thing you should keep in mind, never to keep all your money just in your savings account. You must invest that money into financial instruments like FD, fixed deposit. You have PPF, provident fund. You have EPF, employee provident fund if you are an employee, and other financial instrument like RD, which is recurring deposit. So these are the instrument, these are the safe instrument in which you can put part of your savings, because it gives higher returns. A return more than 6% you can easily get as of now in India it is concerned. For US it may be IRS. So these are the savings. So expenses are the one in which your money will get out of the system, which is basically your leisure activities. You can call it as entertainment. I am writing as ENT, which is entertainment. So entertainment means any sort of leisure activities, watching a movie, going with the friends for a trip, eating outside in a restaurant, dining outside, and other leisure activities which puts money out of your pocket. Expenses also means your monthly rentals, which means the money you pay to the landlord to stay in your flat or the room that you have taken for rent. So it may be entertainment, rent, leisure, activity. So these are the general expense employer individual have when they are earning a certain set of income. Now these are the basic structure. Most of the people get stuck around in this cycle, which is earning an income, saving it and spending it. But then the next stage is assets and liabilities. Very few people go to this particular step and make their wealth system strong. How they do it? Let's find out. So as I said before, assets are something that puts money in your pocket. So assets comes in various shape and sizes. They can be high risk, high reward, low risk, low reward. Let me explain few of them. So in assets, the most common are stocks. Yes, stocks can be asset. If you put money in a blue chip stock like Tata, TCS, you can have companies like Hindustan Zinc, you can have companies like Petronet Chemicals. So these are very profitable companies at the moment. If you put your money buying these stocks, in the long run, they will be beneficial in growing your wealth over time. Second is real estate. Now, real estate means properties, physical properties. You buy a real estate in the name of buying a flat, or you buy a building, or you buy a plot, or you buy a piece of land. All those things come into real estate. Depending upon the market and the situation, the value of real estate booms over time. And let me explain the third, which is currently very common phenomenon now. It is picking up. It's called Bitcoins, or I can say cryptocurrency. So crypto are the high risk, high reward. You can see a lot of millionaires out there because they invested in Bitcoin as early as 2010. And at the moment when I speak, the Bitcoins is already crossing around $60,000. One Bitcoin is equal to $60,000. So I have created a special video for it. I will be releasing it next week. So you can subscribe and watch that video on cryptos. So these are the example of assets, and let me give example of liability. Now, what is liability which puts money out of your pocket? Example, your car. Something which depreciate over time. You buy a car, 1 month after you have bought your car, the value of your car decreased by 33%. That is a depreciation which declined over time. It won't put money in your pocket, it will take money out of your pocket. The second is liability can be your credit card. Credit card can be a big liability. If you are not able to pay your bill on time, this can be a problem. Third can be again your leisure purpose, which means you bought a particular set of item which depreciate over time, is called as mindless purchase. Let's say it's a shopping spree. You purchase a lot of clothes, a lot of antiques, which doesn't have an appreciation in the coming future, and they are worth more now, but down the line they will depreciate and their value will be virtually zero when you want to sell it. So these are the leisure purchases, which also a kind of liability, which put money out of your pocket. No one thinks about the third one. Okay, so the thing is that we have made a system now: income, saving expense, asset and liability. Now, how the money machine works? Now listen it carefully. Whenever you have income in hand, you are positive. You are cash positive, and when you go to savings, you divide into positive and negative. Savings are always positive, expenses are always negative. You pay rent, You save cash, so you know which is positive and which is negative. So now from savings, you put a part of it under financial instruments, which grows over time, like fixed deposit, PPF, EPF. Keep it there and let it grow. Do not disturb your savings. Once you put the money, don't pull it out. Keep it there. And once you have enough savings in hand, you can save money. Let's say you have 1 year plus savings, which can help you run your life or day-to-day spending just by savings. Then from that savings, put some into assets. The easiest way to buy asset is buying a blue chip stocks. Like I said, buy a TCS stock, buy a Petronet stock, or buy a stock like which you believe will be appreciating in coming future. So buying the stock which gives you dividend, put money back into your pocket. And once you grow the savings and slightly you start investing in assets, you grow these assets, it will in the long run put money back into your pocket. So the money you can earn from assets go back to the overall income you make per month or per year. And then if you're spending all into expenses, let's say you're spending all your money into expenses, you're not saving anything, your rental are very high, you're paying 50% of your salary as a rent, then you are declining, going negative. When you go negative, you will need something called as CC, which is credit card. So when your expenses are negative, you don't have savings, you will be using a credit card. And when you use credit card, will automatically enter into a liability. And when you enter into liability, you will buy the stuff, but you don't have money to pay back to the system or to the bank. That means you will be more negative at time. So make sure to keep your liability as low as possible. Yes, you can use credit card if you have a plan in mind to pay it back on time, or you are building a business, you are using a credit from the market, from the bank, and you know the business will earn more return than the interest rate of the bank or the credit card. Then you can use a credit to grow your business. But apart from that, never enter into a liability, otherwise throughout your life it will be a struggle for you. Okay, so let's talk about how the money machine finally works. The flow: take the income, income is here, and from income you enter into savings, you put a portion of your income, you grow this particular block first. Once this block is grown to a particular size, let's say you have a saving for 1 year or 2 years, then slowly you start migrating to assets, buying assets, which is stocks. First you enter into stocks, then part of which put into crypto, which is high risk, high reward. Then when you have more money, put into real estate. When the asset grows over time, you may not need to do a job. It will automatically put money back into your pocket as income. And then you repeat this cycle. This cycle, the green line, one by one, month by month, year by year. That's how you create a money machine. Income, saving, assets. And please remember, this income and saving, you can reach it fast. If your salary is very high, you can earn a savings or build a savings very quick. Let's say it took you 3 to 5 years for an average person earning good salary. It may take him 3 to 5 years to make a good savings account, which totally discipline using these financial instrument. And when that is done, you need to put in assets. It's again a disciplined process which may require you a total of 5 to 10 years minimum. Only after investing into assets for 5 to 10 years you can see a sizable returns. Sometimes it will take 20 plus years. It depends. So be patient. Put the money in your pocket, save and invest. And then you can always put some part to leisure activities. I'm not telling you not to spend anything. You can have, you can watch movies, you can live in good houses, you can have a luxury activities, but make sure this ratio should be controlled. Make a ratio of 1:4, 4 times and 1. So 4:1 means whatever income you have, the fourth part you put into savings and one part into expense, and that fourth part you plan and put into assets, decrease your liability, increase your overall cash. So at the end of the day, you should be cash positive. That is what we need from the money cycle. You need to be cash positive and your assets are strong enough to generate an income for you. You don't need to depend on any other income or any other work. So that's how you make or build a money machine that works. I hope you have understood the video. Please like and share if you like the video, and do watch the video shared on the screen. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care and bye-bye.